Hello guys, my name is Karina and today I'm speaking about ties. I do not think there is another accessory which can make a man look more handsome rather than this one. Of course, all of you probably know this traditional way to wear a tie. It is preferable to have a tie which is narrow but not like this, you know, large one that elderly people prefer for some reason, or people who do not have a taste. Also, you probably know that the length should be up until your belt buckle, and this is all true, this is all good. I'm happy you know this, but let me explain you something else. In order to make your look more unique and creative, inventive, there are different companies who manufacture accessories for ties. Can you imagine? An accessory not for yourself, not for your hand or ear or eyebrow, I mean not earrings or bracelets or stuff like that, but an accessory for an accessory, because a tie itself is an accessory. So an Estonian company called Dimug produces a very nice thing for a tie. It looks like this. Guess what is the purpose? I think you understand that the shape itself matches basically the shape of the knot here. You might ask, why do you need it for? Like, it's all good with a tie here, right? Why do you need it for? Yes, you are right. It is not for keeping the tie straight. It's not for, I don't know, making it be neat and not to swing. It's not for this. This is a completely different item, just to make it look more stylish. Let me just show you. Because sometimes I just talk too much and it's always better to see. In Russian there is a saying, it's better to see once rather than to hear 100 of times, right? So I'm showing it to you. So you put it like this around the knot of the tie, and then on the back side there is a clip. You just clip it, and voila, you have a tie embellished with this pretty thing, which is a leather one. Well, this company also produces belts and bow ties, all from a very special leather. I think they take it from some kind of a Finnish company, and which has been a professional, which has been an expert in leather production for years now. I like it. I personally do recommend it. I think it doesn't matter whether you go to a business meeting with a tie looking like this, or to a party, to some pub or club. It doesn't matter. I think that the glances will be all yours. Even men will ask you where you have bought this and what it is, actually. Because from the first sight, it's not that much obvious what it is. Whether it's whether it comes together with the tie or whether it's a separate detail. So the next way to decorate your tie is to use tie clips. If I told you previously that this accessory for a tie knot is just for making it look more stylish, a tie clip is a different story. Not only it adds a nice accent, but also it has a very practical usage. So let me show you something. Here I have a hammer tie clip, which you basically use not only to make it look more elegant and stylish and so on, but also you want to keep your tie secure. If you, for example, sit down or you dance or you move to different sides, you don't want your tie to, well, move together with you, right? You want to secure it. And not only you use this thing to keep together the front and the back folds of your tie, but you want to secure it to your shirt. There is a rule you must remember, that this thing should go between the third and the fourth buttons of your shirt. So let me just count together with you. So the first will be somewhere here, we cannot see it. Then 2, 3, and 4. So right in between. Okay, let me fasten it. Amazing, isn't it? Absolutely amazing. Excuse me for not being able to tie a tie properly. Well, I'm not sure whether you can see it. This hammer looks amazing, but please guys, do not rely too much on white shirts. It's not necessary to have a white shirt, and especially this dirty one, as I have here. I remember from a lesson at university that was called International Protocol, that a tie should be darker than your shirt, but not darker than your jacket, so lighter than your jacket. So it's not necessary to have this white shirt, it can be any color, but the shirt should be lighter than your tie. I don't know whether you understand me. I hope this makes sense. And this is a leaf. Again, same place, you put it directly here and you should keep it straight. Not like this, please, not like this, not like that. I don't know, not here, not there, not there, not there, because that's too low. And we have a wrench. I'm not sure whether this are suitable for some kind of a builder or something. Not necessarily, perhaps. Builders do not usually wear ties and accessories too. And also, besides clips and bars, you can also use a pin. I guess is more inventive and is less common. The person I associate this pin with is Karl Lagerfeld, who unfortunately has just recently passed away. But if you look at his photos, if you have ever followed him or heard about him, you might know that he was completing his look with this, with different kinds of pins. So he was quite frequently using pins on his ties. Pins can be various, absolutely various. I have this right here, looks beautiful on the black color because there is nice contrast, as you can see. So where to place it? It's simple, you just find the center, the very, very middle of your tie, and place it there. I really have to excuse you, but I do not really know for sure how this accessory is called. Perhaps it must have some kind of a specific name, but it is used also together with a tie. And just a moment, I will show you how absolutely wonderful it is, especially with a black tie. So you hang it like this, absolutely easy to wear it, just like a regular necklace. For me, it looks marvelous. For me, it looks really good. I think it's a very manly accessory. I have not seen many boys, many guys wearing it. I know why, because we need to raise awareness about such kind of products. It's not typical that you would go to a shop and say, I need this thing, you know, the one which you wear over your tie. Not a pin, not a clip, not anything like that, but just this thing. If I don't know how it is called, how can I buy it? So we really need to raise awareness about so wonderful stuff like this. And that's what I'm doing right now. So next one, guys, you will not believe. You must have seen wooden bow ties, but I have never seen a wooden regular tie before. But here it is. So can you imagine? That's the entire tie made of wood. And I'm really happy that this is a Lithuanian company which makes these. It's called Son and Father. Already the name itself is just incredible, isn't it? It's just perfect. It's just perfect. I don't know whether elegant is the word here. It's not elegancy which it adds, but it adds, I don't know, the feeling of a superior taste. If I meet a man wearing this kind of a tie, I would right away understand, well, he has a good taste. If he has a good taste in ties, perhaps he has a good taste in women too, so we might have something in common. I'm sorry. Identical pieces. So these are, you know, separate parts, and you can bend it like this. See? It looks almost like a child's toy. And inside there is a gum, I think, which holds them and keeps them all together. Bravo for the person who invented this. I really do recommend, please buy for your dad, for your friend, for your brother, for whoever. Look at this cutie thing. Guess what it is? That's actually another improvisation of a tie. I think it's really nice and funny. And if you want to look funny on purpose, please do. Because sometimes we're just all tired of this just classic look, which is fine if you don't have any imagination. So I think I've told you everything I wanted for today about ties and about different how-tos related to ties, how to wear them, how to fasten them, how to make fun of them. And by the way, I did mention the company name of these cutie short ties. It's Imago. Yes, so basically, please guys, subscribe, purchase, analyze, pick the one you like, and I think that's it for today. So you will find the link down below. Please be active and stay with me.